And next on my list is Distinguished Representative of Indonesia. You have the floor.
Thank you, Madam Chairperson. Allow me on behalf of my delegation to congratulate you for assuming the role of the chair for this important meeting. Through you, I would also like to congratulate all members of the Bureau. My delegation also thanks the Secretariat led by Special Representative of the Secretary General Margareta Wallström for preparing all substantive and logistical preparation of the meeting, including suggested elements for the post-2015 framework for TRR. Madam Chairperson, my delegation would like to align itself with the ASEAN statement delivered by Myanmar. In addition, allow me to add several additional issues that hopefully might positively contribute to our discussion. For our delegation, it is a matter of principle that our current deliberation should always be connected to the current HFA and that the next framework for action should be based on best practices of the implementation of the HFA. We welcome various progress achieved by member states in implementing several priority of action under the HFA. In particular, disconnecting the strengthening countries' institutional, legislative, and policy frameworks, early warning, as well as disaster preparedness for response. At the same time, it is also important to note that there is still a need to do more in priority for action 4 on the reduction the underlying risk factors and tackling the causes of the risk creation. It is our fervent hope that we will allocate sufficient time to discuss these issues. It is also imperative to note that the key success factor for the current HFA is that HFA provides clear guidance for countries in conducting self-assessment mechanism. In addition, HFA also clearly indicates that the success of the implementation of the framework needs full collaboration among all stakeholders. Madam Chairperson, at this stage, we would like to briefly highlight several points that may be considered to be incorporated in the HFA 2, among others. First, there is a need to always put people first and foremost in the TRR, CCA, and Sustainable Development Agenda post-2015. Second, in order to achieve a more resilient nation, there is a need for building capacity at the local levels, including in assessing disaster and climate risk, as well as mainstreaming TRR and CCA in development plan and policies, which needs to be based on reliable disaster statistics. Third, the use of appropriate technology in early warning and mitigation system need to be supported by strengthening research and development and revitalization of local knowledge and wisdom through the integrated knowledge management system that is accessible for communities. Fourth, we are of the view that there should be a greater commitment and investment by governments in promoting risk-sensitive and resilient economic development. Fifth, there is a need to forge global partnership in addressing TRR at all levels and to enhance the role of the UNISDR, international agencies, and regional and national platform in building resilience at the local and community levels, as well as facilitating knowledge exchange and collaboration among countries. I thank you.
I thank you, Distinguished Representative of Indonesia.